Very good morning, children. Welcome back to the session. Let us continue the remaining part of the lesson, keyboard part 2. Okay, children, in the previous video classes you have learned about the keyboard and also you have learned about the types of keys, isn't it, children? You have learned about alphabet keys and also you have learned about number keys. Yes or no, children? So today you will learn about some special keys. So do you know what are special keys, children? Now observe the keyboard carefully. You can see that there are some more keys on the keyboard other than alphabet keys and number keys. So these keys are known as special keys. They are used to perform some special tasks. So now in this chapter you will learn about some special keys. So there are many special keys, children, apart from alphabet keys and number keys. So today in this chapter you will learn about some of the special keys on the keyboard. Okay, children? So before that, first we will learn about the cursor. So do you know what is a cursor, children? So you might have observed a small blinking line on the screen whenever you have opened an application like MS Word or Word, but or any other application, you have seen a small blinking line as shown in the picture. So a cursor is a blinking line which is seen on the monitor or screen when we type anything using a keyboard. So understood, children? So if you open any application like WordPad or any Word, MS Word or any other application, you can see a small blinking line. So that is called as cursor. Cursor tells us the location or the current position of the screen where the text or numbers will appear. So when we type using keyboard, that means it shows the position of the next letter or number to be entered. And you have, remember, children, you have to always check the position of the cursor before typing. So understood, children? So it shows the position of the next letter or number to be entered. So this is about cursor. So now we will learn about some special keys. So let us learn about special keys. The first one is enter key. So do you know what is the use of enter key, children? So when you observe the keyboard, there are two enter keys on a keyboard. It is the most commonly used key on the keyboard. The enter key is used to bring the cursor to the next line, that is beginning of the next line. Understood, children? So enter key is used to bring the cursor to the beginning of the next line, and this enter key is also known as return key. Okay, children? So now let us see the next special key, spacebar key. So observe the keyboard, children. You can see spacebar key. You can easily identify it, children. The longest key on the keyboard is spacebar key. It is used to give space between the text. That means it gives space between text, means here either words or numbers or numbers or anything, wherever you want space, you can use the spacebar key. If there is no gap between words, it will be difficult to read, isn't it, children? So you have to give gap between words or wherever necessary so that it will be easy to read. So in computer you can give gaps between words and numbers by using this spacebar key. Okay, children? So now let us see the next special key, escape key. So in the keyboard you can observe, children, where is the escape key? It is located in the top left corner of a computer. You can see the top left corner. So that is the escape key. It is used to escape or exit from a task. Okay, children? So its a short form is ESC key. So escape key short form is ESC. So it is, this key is used to cancel or close a pop-up menu or to close or to cancel any operations. Okay, children? The any work in between. So that is the use of escape key. So now let us see the next special key, arrow keys. So observe the keyboard, children. These are the arrow keys. These arrow keys are 4 in number. They are used to move the cursor on the screen. So you all know what is a cursor, children. So the arrow keys are used to move the cursor on the screen or a monitor. So that's why they are known as cursor movement keys. As they are used to move the cursor on a screen, they are known as cursor movement keys. The 4 arrow keys are up arrow, down arrow, left arrow key and right arrow key. So there are 4 arrow keys, as I told you, children. So they are up arrow, down arrow, left arrow and right arrow. The cursor movement keys or cursor control keys are used to move the cursor in any one direction, that is up or down, left or right. So the arrow marks on the keys indicate the direction in which the cursor will move when those keys are pressed. Understood, children? So if you press the up arrow key, the cursor will move towards the upward direction. If you press the down arrow key, the cursor will move towards the downward direction. So if you press the left arrow, the cursor will move towards the left side. And if you press the right arrow, the cursor will move towards the right side. So understood, children? So now, based on this, let us do a small activity, children. Okay, now let us start a small activity based on the topics. So now this is keyboard. Observe the picture of the keyboard carefully and count the number of different types of keys present on it. So now this is keyboard, children. There are different types of keys as I already told you. So now you have to count the number of keys and you have to write in the space provided. So now the first one, let us see. The first one is alphabet keys. Okay, children. So can you tell me, can you count and tell me how many alphabet keys are there? It is very easy because you all know that alphabets are 26 in number. So obviously the alphabet keys are 26. So you have to write 26 in the space. Okay, children. Now let us see the number keys. So now tell me how many number keys are there, children. Here in the keyboard, you can see there are 2 sets of number keys. So here altogether, if you count the 2 sets of number keys, okay, you can see there are 20 number keys on a keyboard. Suppose if any one set is available shown in the keyboard, you can write only 10, so 0 to 9. So as there are 2 sets, okay, you have to write 20. Okay. Now, let us see the next one. Third one is enter key. So as I already told you, how many enter keys are there, children? So there are 2 enter keys. So you have to write 2 in the space. Okay, children. Now let us see the next key, escape key. So tell me, children, how many escape keys are there? Only 1, as I told you. The top left corner, you can see a escape key. Now the next one, arrow keys. You all know how many arrow keys are there? 4. So you have to write 4. Now, children, so total keys. Now you have to write the count all the keys on a keyboard. Okay, children. So if you count all the keys on a keyboard, how many keys can you tell me, children? If you count, there are totally 104 keys. So a keyboard which has 104 keys, standard keyboard. A standard keyboard has 104 keys. Okay, children. So a QWERTY standard keyboard has 104 keys. So QWERTY here means the first row of alphabet keys are arranged in the manner QWERTY. Okay, children. So a standard QWERTY keyboard will have 104 keys. Understood, children? So now let us do some exercises based on the lesson. The first Roman is fill in the blanks. So now tell me, children, a standard QWERTY keyboard consists of how many keys? As I already told you, 104 keys. Very good. Now let us move on to the second one. Dash key is also known as return key. So enter key is also known as return key. Now the next one. Dash keys are also known as cursor movement keys. Can you tell me, children? Yes, arrow keys. So as they are used to move the cursor, they are also known as cursor movement keys. A small blinking line seen on the screen is known as, can you tell me? Yes, it is cursor. So a small blinking line which is seen on the screen is known as a cursor. Now let us move on to the next Roman, true or false. The first one, the longest key on the keyboard is backspace. Is it true, children? No. The longest key is spacebar, not backspace. So you have to write false. Now the second one, there are three arrow keys on a keyboard. Is it true, children? So you all know that there are four arrow keys. So it is false. Next one, there are two sets of number keys on a keyboard. Can you find two sets of number keys, children? Yes. So one above the alphabet keys and another one the numeric pad. So you have to write true. Then now next one, enter key is rectangle in shape. So can you tell me what is the shape of an enter key, children? It is rectangle. So you have to write true. Okay, children, now let us do the next one. Answer the following. So here some questions are given. So you have to write the answers for it. So the first one is, what are the different types of keys on a keyboard? So can you tell me, children, till in this lesson you have learned the different types of keys, isn't it, children? So what are the different types of keys? Alphabet keys, number keys, and special keys. Okay, children, now let us see the next question. What is the use of enter key? So you all know what is the use of enter key, tell me, children. So enter key is used to bring the cursor to the beginning of the next line. Okay, children, now let us see the next question. Name any four special keys on a keyboard. Can you tell me, children? You have learned the special keys. Any four keys you can tell. Spacebar key, enter key, escape key, arrow keys. So these are the special keys. So children, understood. I hope you all have understood. So that's all for today. Here is a small assignment for you all. Write any three special keys on a keyboard. So you can write any three special keys which are seen on the keyboard. Okay, children. So meet you in the next video session. Thank you and have a nice day.